In this video, we show you how to use F5 Application Services 3 extension, or AS3. AS3 uses a declarative model, meaning you can send a declaration file using a single REST API call. The AS3 JSON schema validates the declaration and then produces the BigIP configuration. If that's all new to you, don't worry. This video is pretty high level, and for detailed information on the declarative model, the JSON schema, and other components of AS3, you can see the documentation at clouddocs.f5.com under the Products area, and the link is in the description of this video. AS3 differs from previous versions of F5 application services offerings you may have used, as there's no GUI. You simply post a declaration to create the configuration. There are some prerequisites and important notes for using AS3, as well as a few known issues. Because this type of information can change so quickly, instead of trying to maintain a list in this video, we refer you to the AS3 documentation on clouddocs.f5.com. Before you can use AS3, you have to download it from GitHub and then install it on your BigIP. From the F5 Network's GitHub site, click F5 App Services Extension, the dist folder, and then the RPM file. Click Download, and save it to a location accessible from your BigIP. Once you've downloaded the RPM, you upload it to your BigIP. In this video, we show only the configuration utility for uploading, but you can also use curl. See the documentation for instructions. The very first time you install AS3, you'll need to enable the IAPLX framework if you haven't already. You'll know if it's not enabled, as you won't see the Package Management LX option under the IOPS menu. You only need to do this once, per BigIP, and you must do it from the CLI. So open PuTTY or similar and log on to the BigIP system. Type the following command: touch var config rest IOPS enable. Once you do that, you can return to the configuration utility and refresh the page to see the IAP Package Management LX menu. Now we upload the RPM. So we click Import, click Choose File, browse to where you saved the RPM file, and then click Upload. And now AS3 is ready to use. As you can see, this new BigIP has no configuration objects like virtual servers or pools, and it only has the common partition. So now let's move on to configuring BigIP using AS3. In this example, we are going to post a declaration for a simple web service to the BigIP. This declaration creates the necessary objects to direct traffic to and monitor this web service. The documentation contains a wide variety of example declarations, and you can copy and paste those to see what AS3 can do. We're going to copy the simple Hello World example included in the Quick Start portion of the documentation. So we copy the Quick Start example code. And in this video, we use Postman to send our REST API calls. So feel free to use any RESTful API client or curl. So here we post to the URI HTTPS BigIP IP address, then Management Shared App Services Declare. From the Authorization tab, we choose Basic Auth, and enter our BigIP credentials. Then click Body, and then the raw, and then JSON. Now we paste in our declaration. You can see it has a tenant named Sample1, a virtual server named Service Main, and a web pool with two members. Now we click Send, and wait for the success message. So success is returned, so now we can go back to the BigIP and see what happened. And here we see the sample1 partition was created. And in that partition, a virtual server named Service Main and a pool that contains our servers. AS3 assigns a number of defaults to the configuration, and you can see those defaults by adding a query string to the URI. So here we add ?show=expanded to the end of the URI, and then send the declaration again. And now in the results, you can see the default settings AS3 assigns to the configuration. See the schema reference in the documentation for information on these AS3 options. And the last thing to note here is the declaration returns a no change message, as we didn't change the declaration itself, just added the query string to view the defaults. When you no longer need the configuration, you simply use the delete method. We remove the query string and the body, and then change post to delete and click send. We wait for the success message, and now the configuration has been deleted. And we can verify this by returning to the big IP, and the partition is gone, and when we click virtual servers, our virtual server is gone as well. You can create hundreds or even thousands of application services using a single AS3 declaration, and it takes a tiny fraction of the time it would to manually create these objects on the big IP. You can start to see how this provides a powerful framework to interact with third-party automation and orchestration products. This was only a tiny sample of what AS3 can do. See the documentation for complete information, and stay tuned for future videos on AS3 showing more advanced features and concepts. Thanks for watching.